Yeah. In fact, so you can present the live melody discussion channel or discussion platform.
Welcome back to another show of Life Melody, you know me. I'm J-Town, and we have my OG. Present your name, Musa.
Yeah. As J-Town said, you know, I'm here. Philosopher.
Moses.
As usual, Moses, yeah.
So today is going to be a great show, you know me. Like we used to say, you know what I mean, all this we do is like we just try to give awareness, you know what I mean? That it's not like, and all what we're doing here is like try to educate ourselves and of course give awareness so people can comment and give their own ideas or speculation. But what we're trying to do here is lift up always what's going on in there. In our own struggle, you know what I mean, when it comes to our black people and the community, in our own, what we should be focused on is like how we have to lift up these problems or, and see how we can solve them, you know what I mean, because like that, like they used to always say, we are the only ones who have to solve our problem, nobody can do that. So if we don't speak on these things so we can better ourselves, nothing will change, you understand me? So. This is why we are really speaking about topic like anything that we come up with, you know what I'm saying? So we can share our awareness and you can give your comments and whatsoever, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, that's how we learn and that's how we better ourselves. So yeah, what's up?
Yeah, as you said, welcome back to our discussion, Live Melody. And then today our discussion gonna be about you know the children, you know the African children in abroad and abroad can say in Europe, because we used to think, you know, and analyzing. So today we want to focus about, you know, the children in Europe, African children in Europe. And that discussion is a question which we have been seeing, as everybody know, I hope so too, that is another problem we think that the African children in Europe we have also, and that is, you know, the African children needed to be teached, you know, their own own language and culture, very important. Because you know, we African always we have to have our culture and know our culture. And our language too, very important, as anybody else. But we have the problem from the beginning, because you know, always you have to mention about the, you know, the colonial time. As everybody know, you know, it's a lot of things have been taken from us. The most important, as we say, the language, the culture, because when someone come and take you and goes sell you to other country, other nations who you don't know, you don't have the same culture, and so then that mean he have been taking you and taking your language, taking your culture, because now you are forced to learn another language which is not your own mother tongue, and you are forced to learn another culture which is not your own culture. So that is to weak somebody. So that's why this colonial that can never be forgotten, because that have been weakening the African nation. And then, you know, that's why we have today the mental slavery. So, and this mental slavery, it will take a long time before this can, before we will stand on our own leg. Because the mental slavery, we have been, that mental mean that we have been damaged in our brain for decades of years of other nations, because the way since they come into Africa, European, and also the Arab, and many other nations, so as everybody know, talk about anyone come in Africa and colonize, take the people, the children, and go sell them in other country. We talk about this slave leaders, and as anybody knows, and anyone who have done also, and that one he knows too. But we know this, the history can never lie, it's there. So that's why we never even started yet to learn our own history and the past. And that's why this have to continue. And but now today we are talking about the children in Europe, because the African children in Europe, in abroad, in other any country. So it's very important that the young children, the youth, very important for them to learn their language and their culture. Because if we don't do that, that means still this mental slavery we are talking, it will still continue and grow. Because I know some country, Babylon countries, sometimes even the African black children, so they will think that it's not necessary that they can learn their own mother language, their own home language. But that anyone told you that one is another manipulation. Everybody need to learn your own mother language and your own culture. And anyone told you that it's not necessary, that's one another also manipulation, that's another way to slave you. I believe so. Because when we forget our culture, which many have done, then you see still we are in this same problem. And I know, of course, many have done, but because of lack of lot of circumstances, why? Because as we mentioned last time, you know, African man to come to Babylon and survive is not easy, or an other, you know, foreign country, it's not easy. So, and of course, when we talk about this immigration, to make it in other country, I mean, of course, for us, many African you know, leave the African continent and go to other European countries and so on. It's the lack of looking for better life. But then sometimes, most of the time, you know, the things didn't go according to the dreams. Because depend any country where I and what kind of system is there too. And sometimes it's not easy, you know, to just come and then to understand the system so that you will know how to survive there. So because the system always is a system, and that's not easy to understand sometimes. But yeah, let me now start discuss about that. So I'm here as is a philosopher, Moses, and then Gitan, and I just want to, you know, ask him some little bit of questions, because him, he's the one we are talking about here now, the African children who live in Europe, they're born there, they live here. So, and I understand that it's only here they know, only here they believe, because many of them have never been in Africa, then of course it's normal that they cannot learn anything in Africa because they have never been there. So then the only way they can learn is they have to learn through the parents, or they have to learn in school. So that's why now I'm gonna ask him by himself, and I know many also, they can see themselves, and through this discussion, to ask him how he have been living in his life here, in being in Europe as a black child, and then also the time his childhood, how the parents, what he learned about his culture and language. Yeah. And also, let me just highlight it there at once, so that when we start, I don't need to stop. This still is we are doing this, you know, still to help us Africans also who live in Europe. We have to think. We have to discuss. We have to, you know, give ideas to each other. So that's why we always need to help each other. So this is another way to be united and be strong. So that's the all about. And we need more people in this platform, because it's for us all. Okay, so Gitan.
Yeah.
As he, you heard what I have said now, you listening?
Definitely.
Yeah. So I just want to ask you a little bit, you know, about in this, I mean, European country you have been, I can't say, of course, you born here, you brought up here. And because what I try to say, of course, all your childhood you have done here. So, and how do you see, as you brought up here, and you, how do you see yourself as a black child, and then you know, brought up in Europe? So I can understand. I can understand, of course, you see any country where you're born as your own country, of course. But now the life and living standard, and you know, the situation, the environment, and so on, that first question, that what I want to ask you, and you can highlight it a little bit. And then next, I'm going to ask you about when you were staying with your parents, your childhood time, and then what your parents have learned you about them, about their culture. About the did they learn you your home language, their mother language, and that's the next second question I gonna ask you. But first, as I told you, I've said a black child, and because why I say black child, African child, because all of we are anyhow citizens, but you know, also myself, if you make a question to me how I see it, I know that one, you can say citizen in the paper, it's okay, but still, you know, when they look at, take a good look at you, you know, they see normal, maybe you see your color, and you know. So, because me, I be, I go into the question, it will not disappear, but I be here for many years, but still, I can meet other who they can ask me, where I come from. So, yeah, so, then of course, they tell me that I come from somewhere. Other country, like Africa, of course, they can think. So, or direct, they say, which country in Africa you come from? Mm. You know, I used to say just Africa. Okay, I just highlight this there, but now I come back to the question as I told you.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you explain to the audience, of course.
Yeah, of course. Really, for me to live a life in Europe, you know, me as a black child, you know, I feel like if you really, we can really compare ourselves to the European kids, you know what I'm saying? Because just because you live in, you are born in this country. You have a citizen in this country, you can't really tell yourself that now it's a way to be, say that I belong, you know what I mean? Because that's the, like the, this is what we, the diaspora children struggle with, because it's a struggle to fit in, you know what I'm saying? We're trying to belong, while we know that's the price, you know what I mean? We pay to live in a country as Europe, you know what I mean? To try to fit in, to try to have a life, you know what I mean? Try to fit in society and in the environment. It's not an easy thing, you know? And this is what makes most of the time, you know what I mean? We, as a black child, you know, we struggle with ourselves because of belonging and try to fit in the society that is not yours, you know what I mean? That is not, you know, that people who don't really look like you, you know what I mean? You want to fit in, you want to try to, you know, have a life here, but what can you do, you know what I mean? It's not like, that's why it's really important, like, you know, once you start to know who you are, you know what I mean? It's make it more easy for you to fit in, you know, not like fit in like that, but to understand how to live your life in this country. But if you don't really know yourself like that, you know what I'm saying, you don't know, you know, so much about your history, you know, you have it difficult to live your life in this Europe, you know what I mean, because people think that, you know, all the time when you are living in a country like this, it's like you're in paradise, which is not, you know what I mean? That's like, you know, that's small-minded when you're thinking about like that, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, we don't have the same opportunity as this child, you know what I mean? So this is the problem all the time we face in this country. Because of most of the time, we don't understand, like, you know what I mean? It's really, we can, even though we are in their country, we live in their society, we can never achieve the same goal. Yes, we could be friends, because they could be friends with them, we could be friends with them. But at the end of the day, when it comes to career and everything, they're the ones who are going to be more forward, because this is their system. So they, of course, their system is going to do what's right for them. But you, as an outsider, you're going to have it more difficult, you know what I mean? You're not going to fit in as you want to fit in. So this is what we, most of us outsiders, when we're in this country, really struggle with, I think. Understand?
Yeah. Yeah, but you say here, like you don't have the opportunity. You don't think that it's because of depend according to how much you struggle and to have that opportunity, in even though you are in this country or whatever you are. So it's, you think it's not because of your struggle and to have that opportunity. You think it's not that, might be, of course, if you struggle hard, like themselves, like their children, you don't think that you could also reach that opportunity, your dream?
I mean, if you look at it, at the end of the day, it's like, even though they used to always say, you know, as an outsider, we have to work twice hard than them, you know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, this system is already designed for them, you know what I mean? That's how it's designed for them to succeed. But you, as an outsider, you know what I'm saying, if you want to even make it in that system, it will not even be, yes, you can be one or two can have a chance to make it, but it's not going to be many. Understand?
Yeah, understand.
That's
yes.
The difference.
Yeah, yeah. Because you know, when we come to this, as usual, you know, sometimes you have to be hard talk.
Yeah.
Because you know, what the most important in this, I can say, our platform. We are not here sitting and joke, and we are not here either sitting and pretending. You know.
True.
We don't get, you know, pay for this, so we always talk hard talk.
Yeah.
So, and that's the whole about. That's the difference with our platform and with many other platforms.
True.
We cannot say, yeah, money is nothing, or, you know, we don't do for money, or, of course, if we get to, so why not? But as we know, we don't get paid, so we cannot sit here and talk shit. So that's why, still, I come into this question. As you say, yeah, like, then in this case, we Africans, so if we come in this Babylon country, so we have to talk, like, we have to work like a double.
Definitely.
So before we can get.
That's true.
You don't think that is like normal and or fair that case?
I mean, it's like, it's not a fair thing, but that's why we have to understand it. Like, it's not designed for us to really make it. So when we understand, that's why I feel like when we understand it's not designed for us to make it, for our children to make it.
Mm-hmm.
So it will be a good thing, like, if we were united people. So when we come to a country like this, we foreigners, we unite, you know, and try to create our own, because that's how we help our own too, our own people and our own children.
Mm.
But otherwise, when we come into a country like this, that everybody's divided, our people, as I say, speaking from our people, is divided.
Mm.
To live in a society like this, white man society, of course, is difficult.
Mm.
That's why that's the struggle for many young children here, to try to make it as. To achieve the same goal as the white privileged child, it's not going to be easy. You know what I mean? Like I said, it's only one or two that maybe who even be accept to be in the same position. But to say they're many, nah, it's not going to. You know, like we always say, they're going to block us.
Yeah. Okay. Now, if I get your point,
gotcha.
Is that the force? If I get your point and understanding, first, we Africans, we have to struggle and work hard like double.
Exactly.
So that if we can, you know, reach our goal.
True.
Isn't it?
Yeah, to even get a position,
yeah,
you have to work twice as hard
yeah.
as them, yeah. more than them.
Yeah, is it the same thing,
yeah.
the goal and because exactly. what you wish to be?
True.
Half or B.
Definitely.
So we have to work double.
Yeah.
Okay. That one is a good because what I can comment in that is that as the you know the audience is listening and our people also I hope that we have to learn and to understand. In this case necessary and important and reality.
True.
Because sometimes maybe our people also will think, I come to this country, to Babylon or whatever, so, you know, yeah, have a lot of dream, I just come and then I can be a lawyer, I can be a doctor, I can be this, I can have money and, you know, all that kind of dreams. Yeah, you can be all that, you can have all that, but you have to think also you come to Babylon and of course, it's good to know the system, and that mean now as Gitan, understand very well, it's like giving advice. Then we have to know, we have to work double before we can not even be equal like them, but before we can, you know, get something,
sure.
Closer the to the. Things we are dreaming
for sure.
And also, as you say, this system, it's or the country or everything is not designed for us.
Definitely.
So then that also is good. For us to understand that one. Also, in that case, it's one of the reality. That is one of the reality. So if it not to be designed for us, and that also that means also that one is a normal. So because why they should be here and designed for us?
Exactly. I mean, because when we thinking maybe for us maybe we might think like okay, it's supposed to be like humans' right. But it's not, when you come to a country that is not really, I mean, who feel like it's there, it's not really, it's like, you come to another culture.
Mm-hmm.
A culture that is not really designed for your own culture.
Mm-hmm.
How can you think, maybe human rights, but even if you are thinking human rights, you gotta follow their own principle of human rights.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not your the way you want, not your like way of that code, because it's not designed for our culture. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
We come to settle in their culture, so it's like we gotta follow their culture.
Mm-hmm.
But even in their culture, that's not designed for us
mm-hmm.
to win.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's designed for them.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, that's a it's so unfair to understand, to think like, you know what I mean, we're gonna make it, it's supposed to be equal.
Mm-hmm.
No, because it's not designed for our culture to make it.
Mm-hmm.
It's their culture, it's designed for them.
Yes, I understood, but in a way, first I can say, now I talking to the Babylon, it's like a Gitan feel like a, you know, this system, the Babylon system is not designed for like maybe you feel like for African, and also this when we say human rights, so I some people think every human, but sometimes as he's feeling also is that it's every human, but it's not like exact every human. It's like they are on human right and on their culture right. It's designed in that. Then in that case, if the other one think, you know, okay, human right, I'm human too, so I have right too, then maybe there is the misunderstanding exactly. In that case.
Sure.
But still, now I can say, but if you look at yourself, as I say again, you born in this Babylon, you brought up here, you don't know nowhere, you don't have country, you don't have that thinking, you don't have that feeling that, yeah, I belong to there. You have these feelings with, that you are belong where you born and you brought up.
Mm.
You understand?
Yeah.
So then in this case, if to be fair, then you are 100% should be counted in this what is the human right and even their culture, because like it might be me, I come when I grow up at least, you understand, but like you, the youth who born here and grow up here,
yeah.
And normal, it's your country, it's my country too, because I'm a citizen of this country, but you are more because you didn't even travel come, you just, your parents travel come, but you born here, you grow up here.
Mm.
Then in this case, the whole human right, you should get it. But then in this case, if you don't get it that, as sometimes you don't get it, then in this case, that's now is my question, then do you think that is fair to you in that case? Or how do you see yourself? Or how?
It would be silly for me to think like that. Yes, I suppose to have the same. You know what I mean? Yes, of course. Most of us who born here think like we supposed to have that right. You know what I mean? Because we born here and we don't know nothing else than the here we born. But that's why now the question comes, like, our parents have to really install that in our mind, you know what I mean? When they're now there, and they are more responsible to teach us ours, to who we are, you know what I mean? Why we're not gonna have the same right as them, you know, so we know from the start who we're dealing with, you know what I mean? Than to just think that we're supposed to have that. Because if I'm going freely, living this life freely in their system, of course that is it will be the struggle for me. While struggling, while I'm fighting, and I know that I'm thinking that I'm supposed to have the same right, but I can't, because my parents have never teach me that to understand that, you know. You, of course, you're born here, but you have to understand this is not your culture, you know what I mean? So you're going to have it difficult to fit in with this young friends here.
Yeah, I understood. This one now is going to be more hard and hard.
Understand
that. Yeah, it's going to be more hard and hard to talk as usual. Because, again, of course, like I can say, your parents, they come, okay, and I say again, because I know me myself how I